You get onto the topic of just how magic Tasmania is, and I guarantee you, worldwide, you can't beat the show this place puts on at night. After sunset, with little artificial light and some of the world's cleanest air, our skies open up to the heavens, displaying millions of sparkling stars. Quite regularly, this can be accompanied by a show of the Aurora Australis. Look down and you'll find bioluminescent algae lapping against our shores. And if you were to head inland to the forest, you can be guided a trail by our ghost fungus. Yep, that's right, ghost fungus, aka Umphalotus nidiformis. Creamy white in the daytime, this fungi undergoes a spectacular transformation at night. This is due to an enzyme reaction called luciferin, resulting in the emission of light, much like a firefly. Ghost mushrooms occur all around Tasmania, and the best time to look for them is in autumn. And while you can see these glowing with just the naked eye, the best way to capture them is by photographing them by a DSLR.
Yeah, you know, those bulky things people used to use before iPhones.
Alright, so one thing you're going to want to do before you start photographing these mushrooms is you're going to have to locate them. So this spot that I'm here at today with Erin is Dooley's Hill in Latrobe, and there has been many mushrooms reported in this area. We're not too sure if it's too early on in the season, but we're going to start by just searching up in some of these walking tracks, and we're just going to be looking out for the general characteristics of the ghost mushroom, which is basically like an oversized oyster mushroom. So what kind of spots are we looking for, Erin, when we're looking for ghost mushrooms?
Ghost mushrooms are found under dead or dying trees.
Uh-huh.
So that's what we're looking for.
Right, dead or dying trees.
Mm-hmm. There's a mushroom.
Oh yeah. First mushroom. I do not believe that that one is a ghost. But that's a dead or dying tree.
Yeah. It's not a ghost though.
Nah, this would be the best backdrop for a ghost mushroom.
Mm.
If we could just like plant one in there.
Oh, we'll go steal the other one. Okay.
Getting nothing. There's like no mushrooms. There's hardly any mushrooms at all. In general.
I don't like this negativity, Rob Parsons. What about...
No go. We had a pretty good search here. Did like a big figure of eight. Pretty much checked everywhere that we could, and we didn't come across any ghost mushrooms. So what we're going to do is we're going to jump in the car and we're going to go and check out Henry's Somerset Reserve, which is about 5 minutes drive from here. I've found ghost mushrooms there before, and that's kind of like our only hope at the moment.
It's Rob's secret spot.
My secret spot, yes it is. Gentle lady.
It's not photo worthy, but it's that one.
I don't think that is, no.
What's his underside look like?
Kind of too yellow, maybe?
Oh.
Yeah. it's a ghost stunt double. We've ran out of GoPro and pretty much given up. And we're walking through here, this little bit of forest, and guess what we found? Freaking ghost mushroom. Check it out. Right here. It's like very close to the end of the day, and holy crap, it's a decent size one too.
Look at him. There's even a little baby one here.
It's gonna be so sick to see how much they glow.
He's got a little
nibble. Bite marks taken out of him.
Mm.
But it looks like
perhaps from this angle.
Yeah. Yep, that'll be awesome. Sick. All right. Well, we're going to have to come back here when it's dark. So that's going to be in like half an hour or so. So we'll go and get some food and then we'll see you in about now. We're back at the spot now. It's dark enough to start shooting. We got the camera out. There's like five things that you're going to have to change on your camera before you even start shooting. The first one you're going to change is from auto to manual mode. You're going to want total creativity when it comes to shooting the ghost mushrooms. and this is the reason why. First thing that you need to change is your shutter speed. So we're going to go ahead and crank this up to the maximum, which is 30 seconds. The next one is your f-stop or aperture, and we want to have it as open as possible, which is the lowest number possible with this lens is 4.0. And then we go into the ISO or the sensitivity. Now you don't want to have this cranked up to the max because you'll get grainy pictures, but you do want to find somewhere about halfway between. So I think 3200 is a pretty good number for this. Focus, we're going to need to change to manual mode. And also the drive mode, we want to put on a 2 second timer. So this is going to eliminate any camera shake that you get when you press the shutter. Since we're shooting for such a long amount of time, half a minute, that'll just cancel out any bullshit repeating myself. So once you've got all those things there locked in, you're ready to go and set up the focus and start composing the shot for the mushroom. All right, so since we're using quite a wide lens here, I'm gonna be getting pretty tight on the subject. So that there's not too bad. You can see the whole mushrooms in frame. Now, this is the tricky part. Remember how we put the focus on manual before? So we're gonna be spinning the focus ring here. And as you can see down below, those gills are getting sharper. And once you've gone past sharpness and they start blurring again, you know you've gone too far. So you just wanna fine tweak that until you get it somewhere pretty sharp. That looks pretty good to me.
That's nice.
So that's basically it. We've done everything that we possibly can to give it the best opportunity at getting a good photograph. Now all that's left to do is switch the light off and hit that shutter.
Ooh,
nice.
Damn.
It looks pretty cool. Look at that glow.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Yeah, not bad. I feel like it'd be awesome if we could somehow like get you and the mushroom in the same shot, but I'm not 100% sure how we could do it. Maybe if I use the tripod and then we could try like a composite image. So I'll get a photo with just the mushroom and then we'll get a photo of just you being lit up and then we put them together maybe.
Right, because if I'm bright enough, the mushroom's not going to glow, right?
Exactly. Yeah, if we only brighten you up, the mushroom won't glow.
Yeah.
And if we only rely on the mushroom to light you up,
I'll be dark as.
You'll be dark as.
Okay.
Yeah. So we'll have to cheat a little bit, I guess, and do two images in the same spot and combine them.
Okay.
Let's try that out.
Let's do it.
I was trying to be cool and do it all one-handed while filming. Okay, you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Set. 3, 2, 1. Decent.
Okay.
Yeah, that looks really good. I think if we can, hold that. Let me just focus again. So we just want to. Maybe about. There. Yep. All right. Very nice.
Okay.
I'm
going to get up. Oh, that's nice.
Cool.
I like the little guy in the corner. Did you see him?
Mm. Yeah, I made sure to get him in. Okay, we're done now. The mozzies are eating us alive and we got heaps of cool photos. So we're going to go back to the computer and see what we can come up with. So out of all the photos that I shot, I have settled on this one here. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is just open up Photoshop, and I'm going to take that photo of Erin and just drag that in. Now,
going to need to make a few adjustments on this. The first one I'm going to do is just bring a green tint in so that this kind of blends in with the whole mushroom idea. Might just increase the exposure a little bit, add a little bit of contrast, see if we can get some of those shadows pop out. I'm just going to drop the whites. And it's looking pretty good. I might just add a little bit of dehaze as well. And just go ahead and open image. So that's going to open up a tab in Photoshop. Now I'm going to do the same with the mushroom. And just have a little edit on this one as well. Just bear in mind, guys, I'm not a pro at this. Kind of just have a very vague idea on how all this kind of stuff works. So this one here is quite underexposed, so I'm going to go ahead and increase the exposure. As you can see, it's quite grainy, but we should be able to reduce some of that with a couple of these slides. So add a little bit of contrast. Let's drop the highlights down and just boost a little bit of the shadows and the whites, and the blacks can come down as well. So you can see it's kind of like this noisy stuff on there. Just by lowering the texture, should be able to reduce a lot of that. And this dehaze button's pretty cool. So sliding this to the left actually gives off like this kind of aura on the ghost mushroom, which I really like. So that looks pretty good to me. I might just add a little bit of vibrance and then we'll go ahead and combine these two images. So what I'm going to do is, first of all, just select all and copy this image and drop it on top of the image with Erin. I'm going to need to make sure that they're in line, so I'll just take the opacity of the top image and put it down to about 50%. As you can see, the mushroom doesn't quite line up, so I'm just going to drag that over. So we've got a nice match there, or near enough anyway. Now that I've done that, the opacity can come back. See this spot where Erin's head is? It has the kind of window through the trees. I'm just going to paint that in. Actually, I might paint in a bit of the sky while I'm at it, just to give it a little bit of more of a darker feel. So we're going to the brush here. So we want to increase that opacity. So that's pretty good there, and then I can drop the opacity back down and just kind of want to paint in some of this eyesore that is the sky behind, so it's not as distracting. Can probably increase the size there. A bit more opacity probably won't hurt either. And just smash out some of that. Yep. Look, that's not too bad. I'm going to run with that. So you can see the image behind, the image in front. Now what we want to do is just slowly start erasing the front image and revealing the behind image. So to do that, to start with, we can just drop the opacity down. So I'm just going to slightly get Erin on the left-hand side. And just kind of patch in a couple of the boundaries here so I know what I'm working with. Putting the opacity back up to 100% will give me some idea of what's showing on her body. And probably just reduce the opacity but increase the size of the brush here. And this is where you can kind of fine-tune how much is going to be shown. I think that's not too bad, but it's looking a little bit scat. I'm just going to lower that opacity even more, increase the brush size even more, and just kind of keep painting until we get like a semi-believable exposure. I mean, so far it looks pretty freaking dope. but we're gonna be able to make this look a little bit more realistic soon. That's not too bad. So now what we can do is increase the brush size and start working a little bit around the mushroom. Start showing some of that foreground and just giving it a little bit more flow towards the mushroom. We might introduce that tree trunk as well. So just working up and down the trunk, slowly revealing that image that we have behind. I don't know, not too bad for a couple of minutes. Pretty happy with that. But yeah, you could edit this for hours and kind of make it perfect, but the whole point of this was just to kind of give you an idea on what you can do if you were to finish this off. I would just, as you can see around here, I've got the border which shows the behind image, and I would probably just flatten the image and then just select this amount and copy it onto a new canvas, and then you're pretty well done.
Yeah, so that's it. Actually came up pretty good for a quick little edit. Hopefully you guys got some sort of value out of this video. It's only very early on in the mushroom season, so make sure you dust off those cameras, get out there and get snapping. Tag me in your pictures too, I want to see them all. And I'll leave a link below in the description where you can view the interactive map that shows all the locations across Tasmania where you can go out and find ghost mushrooms. Hit the thumbs up if you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you all very soon.